Assalamu alaikum. My brothers and sisters, we all suffer at some point or another heartbreak, or things do not go exactly as we had planned. This is from Allah. We say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Indeed, we belong to Allah. He controls everything. He decides when we were born. He decides what will happen, what won't happen. He decides when we're going to go back to Him. And the decision is His. That is Allah. Wa inna ilayhi raji'un. And indeed, we are all going to return to Allah definitely. So that statement, Allah Almighty says, Alladhina idha asabathum musibatun. Allah says, those whom when calamity strikes them or something negative strikes them, they are quick to say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Allah says, Bashir as-sabirin. Give good news to them. They are the patient ones. In fact, the Bashir as-sabirin comes first. Give good news to the patient ones. Who are they? Truly patient people are those whom, when news comes to them, when something happens to them that is negative, they say, Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We belong to Allah. And you know, He controls everything. He owns us. He decides everything. The ultimate decision is His. And we will return to Allah Almighty. So that is something we are taught in the Quran. Allah also speaks about testing us by not giving us things that we desperately want. We would all love our parents to live forever, ourselves, our siblings, our spouses, our children to live forever and to be the best and to have things the way they want. Everyone wants to pass examinations. Sometimes you won't. People may pass away from around you. Sometimes you desperately want something and Allah wants to delay it a little bit, but you want it urgently. Sometimes Allah doesn't want to give you something you desperately want. And sometimes there is a huge barrier between you and something and Allah wants to give it to you. Allah will give it to you. And if there is no barrier between you and something and Allah does not want to give it to you, it's not going to happen. So we need to attach with Allah and to Allah. Heartbreaks are common. Sometimes people go through divorce. Divorce is something you wonder. These people went through a wedding. They loved each other. They married each other. They invested so much. They went through, mashallah, tabarakallah. They may have children. They may have grandchildren. And they then break up. You know, people get upset when an engagement is broken. True. But people get even more upset when a marriage is broken. Subhanallah. If only you knew when you bear sabr, when you take it in your stride, when you know you've given it your best shot, when you know you are a patient person, you must realize Allah does one of a few things. He either grants you what you want later on, or He replaces what He has taken away from you with something far better than that. And this is Allah. Some people lose their spouses, for example. Some people lose a child. Some people lose property. Some people, like I said, failed in exams. But sometimes their businesses are burnt down. Real fires have happened and eaten up entire businesses. Do you bear patience? Do you realize there was a day when you had nothing? Allah took care of you and He will take care of you again and again and again. That is Allah. So develop a relationship with Allah and understand the nature of this dunya. This worldly life is temporary. It is definitely temporary. So for us to think that we will have permanent solution to our problems, that's not possible. The only permanent solution is when you get paradise. That's why Allah Almighty concentrates or wants us to concentrate on the point of Jannah. Jannah, He speaks about it all the time. Forget about the problems and difficulties of this world. Every day you will face a different type of a challenge. People will say things, people will accuse, you will lose your job, you will lose your money, you will lose your marriage, you will lose loved ones, you will, everything will happen. You may have anxiety, you may have fear, you may have, that's what Allah says, لَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ. We will test you with a little bit of the following things. And the first thing He speaks about is anxiety. He speaks about uncertainty. He speaks about fear, fear. Fear from all angles. So Allah says, we will test you with that. Why? Because we want you to rely on us totally. Rely on us, call out to Allah. He's the owner of the door that you want opened. He is the owner of the door that you want opened. So knock on His door and He will open your door. Subhanallah, subhanallah. So we have conviction. We've all, myself included, have been through things that have really almost broken us or broken us. And sometimes, subhanallah, we've been through challenge upon challenge. We wonder, why is this happening to me? Don't ask in a defying way. If you're asking in a way to correct yourself or to look into a different perspective, to improve your relation with Allah, alhamdulillah. But if you're asking in a way that is defying the decree of Allah, then subhanallah, we need help. My brothers, my sisters, remember, we all go through different types of challenges. You know, I've come across people who they've lost their children either through death or through having lost the path. Allah will bring that child back. Allah will bring the child back. You just need to know how to navigate. Number one, through your crisis. Number two is to call out to Allah, who is the owner of the heart of that child as well. So yes, sometimes our children are victims of bad company. But subhanallah, we realize, the sooner we realize that these children are the children given by Allah, and we need to keep trying with them. You know, people say, should I cut off my child completely because they did something that I don't agree with? Well, it depends what environment you're living in and whether or not that would bring them back. The idea of cutting someone off when they've done something really wrong would only be in order to try and win them back, in order to try and make them feel that they've done something wrong and bring them back. But if you feel that that's going to make matters worse, then you don't do that. If you think that that will never bring them back, then you don't need to do that. You don't have to do that. Unless, obviously, they are contaminating others in the process, then you might want to keep them at a distance. But to cut off someone completely, when you know that if you kept a slight relation with them, there would be a chance, even if it's 4 or 5 years from now, that you will win them over again. That particular case, what would be the wise thing to do? May Allah Almighty bless us. Sometimes Allah Almighty wants us to continue calling out to Him. I've seen so many people struggle maybe to get married and struggle to get a job. But the day they do get that job, it would have come after patience, after trying and keep on trying, then they get it. So alhamdulillah, I thought on this beautiful night of Ramadan, let me remind myself to begin with that these things happen. And we face challenges, no problem. We take it in our stride and we ask Allah's guidance and we ask Allah to help us. So my brothers and sisters, every one of us will go through issues, sometimes a health issue, health matter. Suddenly you're diagnosed something serious. Take it in your stride. Miracles do happen. Many times doctors have said things and they've told people the reality on their side, but the reality on the Almighty's side can change everything. I've seen people living who were given a few days to live by doctors, but Allah has chosen that their lives will turn around. So if Allah, the giver of life from no life, is able to give you that life from nothing, don't you think He's able to extend that life? If Allah could create you from zero, don't you think He can cure you from diseases when doctors have given up? Who is the greatest of all? Is that not Allah? Allah will grant you, have hope. And if we die with hope, we will die the correct death with the correct relationship with Allah. But if you lose hope, you're distancing yourself from Allah Almighty. My brothers and sisters, I hope these few words could empower all of us, myself included. And like I say, you look at someone in the eyes and you don't even know what they must be going through. Everyone goes through so much. Don't just swipe at people. Put yourself in their shoes and walk 10 kilometers before you even utter a word. Because you may just wrong them so badly and you don't know, you're just judging no matter what. So may Allah Almighty grant us ease and goodness and open our doors and give us the best of this world and the next. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد.